Welcome to our daily devotion. The Methodist Church of Barbados invites you to sing, pray, and worship with us as we declare God's glory and celebrate His mighty acts.
James Street Spicetown Circuit proudly presents the Palm Sunday Youth Rally on March 24th from 4 p.m. Prepare to be inspired, empowered, and filled with the triumphant spirit of Jesus. We're taking the theme even further this year, triumphant with Jesus, fighting like champions. This is a rallying cry for the warriors of faith. Discover how to fight life's battles with strength and courage. Big or small, this is a celebration. Hear incredible stories from young champions facing adversity and emerging victorious through unwavering faith in Jesus. Worship like never before. Our live band and praise team will lead a heart-pounding, soul-stirring celebration of Jesus' triumph. Come on, lift your voices, raise your hands, and let His Spirit fill this place. This Palm Sunday Youth Rally will be epic. Invite your friends, your family, and neighbors. Let's get this celebration echoing far beyond these walls. Save the date, mark your calendars, and prepare for the Palm Sunday Youth Rally. Triumphant with Jesus, fighting like champions. Rise, conquer, and triumph with Jesus Christ. See you there.
Dear God and Heavenly Father, we thank you for your amazing power and work in our lives. We thank you for your goodness and for your blessings over us. We thank you for your great love and care. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your sacrifice so that we might have freedom and life. Forgive us, Lord, when we don't thank you enough for who you are, for all you do, and for all you've given. Help us to set our eyes and our hearts on you afresh. Lord God, renew our spirits. Fill us with your peace and joy. We love you and we need you this day and every day. And we give you praise and thanks, for you alone are worthy. God, we thank you for the blessing and joy of family. We thank you for those who are gathered with us this evening to hear your word. May we all see the many ways you provide for us, comfort us, and protect us. Lord, teach us to offer you a heart of thanksgiving and praise in all of our daily experiences of life. Teach us to be joyful always, to pray continually, and to give thanks in all of our circumstances. We accept them as your will for our lives, Lord. We long to bring pleasure to your heart daily. Break the power of the enemy in our lives, Lord. Defeat him through our sacrifice of praise. Lord God, change our outlook and attitude into one of joyful contentment and gratitude with our present circumstances. Jesus, we want to be like you who obeyed the Father without complaint. You embraced the chains of humanity when you walked this earth. Convict us, Lord, whenever we complain or compare ourselves with others. Give us your attitude of humility and thankful acceptance. We want to be like the Apostle Paul, who learned contentment in every circumstance. We choose to continually offer you a sacrifice of praise. The fruit of lips that give praise to your name, Lord. We long to bring a smile to your face. Teach us the power of a thankful heart. We know that your truth dwells in a thankful heart. Dear Heavenly Father, it's easy to point our fingers at others when they forget to thank us. But you show us that it's also very possible that we are forgetting to thank you and others for the blessings in our own lives. So help us to follow in the footsteps of the one leper who remembered to come back and thank Jesus. And so we want to grow in our attitude of gratitude, Lord. Father God, today we thank you for the provisions of our life. We thank you for the people in our lives. We thank you for the opportunities you have given to us in our lives. We thank you for the acceptance and forgiveness you have lavished upon us in spite of our sinful actions and choices. We thank you for the healing you have brought into our lives, physical and emotional. We thank you for the way you have brought us back from the darkness that lurks in our soul and the choices that we could have made that would have landed us in a pit. And so we bring all these prayers before you this evening. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
scripture readings are taken from Proverbs chapter 9, verse 9, Ephesians chapter 4, verse 7, and verses 11 to 13, and 2 Timothy chapter 2, verses 1 to 2. I begin. Proverbs chapter 9, verse 9. Give instruction to the wise, and they will become wiser still. Teach the righteous, and they will gain in learning. The word of the Lord. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 7 and 11 to 13. But each of us has given grace according to the measure of Christ's gift. Verse 11. The gifts he gave were that some would be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers, to equip the saints for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ, until all of us come to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to maturity, to the measure of the full stature of Christ. The Word of God. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verses 1 to 2. You then, my child, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus, and what you have heard from me through many witnesses, entrust to faithful people who will be able to teach others as well. The word of the Lord.
My all in all, here in the love of
Good evening, brothers and sisters in Christ. This evening, I will be sharing with you on Christ-centered mentorship. Christ-centered mentorship. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we wait to hear a word from you. You said in your word that your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. And so, Lord, open our ears, open our minds, open our hearts to receive all that you have to share with us. May we be able to apply it to our daily lives. And so let the words of my mouth and the meditation of all of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. Christ-centered mentorship. You then, my child, be strengthened by the grace that is in Christ Jesus. And what you have heard from me in the presence of many witnesses, entrust to faithful men who will be able to teach others also. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verses 1 to 2. Brothers and sisters, regardless of your age, if you are Christian, then you are called to mentor others. Reliable Christ-centered relationships are one of the primary ways God transforms his people. Whether that excites you or terrifies you, it is part of God's plan that we invest ourselves in others. Simply put, mentoring means developing a teaching relationship to help others see what it looks like to follow Jesus. This requires imitating Christ in all we do and becoming love as the foundation of who we are. Why? Because we cannot teach what we don't know, and our example speaks much louder than our words. Our example speaks much louder than our words. To teach and relate well, we must prioritize our maturity in Christ, my friends. Here are some guidelines taken from Paul's writing. 1, we must die to self, where we seek God's truth above our own. 2, we need to know our true identity and stop trying to prove ourselves. We are an adopted child of the King. 3, we must remain humble so that we can continue growing. 4, we must practice integrity. In other words, always doing the right thing even when nobody is looking. 5, we must embrace community. Mature leaders and mentors rely on each other for accountability and support. They practice humility and have fun together while taking their faith seriously. 6, we must empower others. We must seek to help those we mentor exceed our own maturity by equipping, encouraging, and educating them with God's truth. We must believe in them when they can't believe in themselves. We must know, brothers and sisters, that God wants us to be authentically us. You don't have to role play or pretend to have advanced expertise to inspire others to excel in everything. And we see this in 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 7. Mature mentors are secure in Christ and firm in their faith. They aren't trying to self-promote because they're so excited about participating in God's projects and purposes. It's a high calling, and yet God extends it to everyone. And so, my friends, who has God placed in your life that you feel led to mentor? Remember, age isn't the most important criterion. Maturity is what matters in mentoring. We need to consider walking alongside those who are younger in the faith and offer our life experiences, both positive and negative. We need to be able to point them to God's greater purposes. Remember, my friends, there is a difference between a good story and a God story. The former might be exciting, but lacks God's redeeming power. But remember, a God story always encourages faith, hope, and love. How many times have you said to yourself, "I wish someone would have told me this sooner"? My friends, we all have lessons we've learned in our past seasons of life. We all have helpful knowledge to share with others. Some of us have been fortunate enough to have mentors in our lives to guide us and help us fail softly. Others have not. When done correctly, mentorship can change a person, an individual, and it can even alter his or her legacy. When I reflect on my walk with Christ, I'm able to clearly see the path that God led me down years ago as a new believer, and I can see the mentors that God had placed in my life and that God continues to place in my life. Mentors are people you see doing something successfully and people you want to learn from. You could learn from a mentor on the subject of business, relationships, your relationship with Christ, or any other topic you can think of. Maybe you know someone at church who is excellent at studying their Bible, or who has an amazing marriage, or who operates a thriving business, and you want to learn how to operate in a similar manner. So my friends, this can be an excellent opportunity for us to build a mentor slash mentee relationship. In every stage of life, my friends, we should be looking for a mentor and we should be mentees. Every Paul needs a Timothy and every Timothy needs a Paul. Mentorship is about making others around us better. Better husbands, wives, students, mothers, fathers, leaders, managers, employees, and Christians. Proverbs chapter 13, verse 20 reminds us, "Walk with the wise and become wise. Associate with fools and get in trouble." Here are some helpful guidelines for being a mentee or a mentor as we explore this opportunity in our lives. So what is the role of a mentee? 1, do not ever let or allow the fear of rejection stand in the way of you asking someone to be your mentor. No matter their position in life, the answer is always no if you don't ask. 2, be on time. 3, come prepared with questions, homework complete, and something to take notes with. 4, turn off your phone. 5, be respectful and humble. And so what is the role of a mentor? 1, ask yourself, what can I do to help guide this mentee and help him or her discover God's will for his or her life? 2, be respectful and humble. 3, once it has been established what you and your mentee need, come prepared to mentor. 4, challenge your mentee, but have grace with them as they learn. And 5, set a mentorship start and end time frame. Consider for a moment a young tree, my friends. It easily bends and sways, thrashing about in a storm. In contrast, an old oak stands strong amidst the changing seasons. One method to secure and stabilize a young tree is to tether it to an older, more mature tree. In a similar way, the mentoring relationship is one where a younger believer is tethered to a more mature believer for a season so that she or he might grow firm in their faith and be equipped for ministry. One passage in particular that refers to this is Ephesians chapter 4, verse 7 and verses 11 to 13, which you heard earlier. Paul encourages the church. But grace was given to each one of us according to the measure of Christ's gift. And he gave the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, the shepherds and teachers to equip the saints for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ until we all attain to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to mature manhood, to the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ, so that we may no longer be children, tossed to and fro by the waves and carried about by every wind of doctrine, by human cunning, by craftiness in deceitful schemes. The apostle, prophet, evangelist, shepherd, and teacher all have one goal in their training. That is, to equip the saints for the work of ministry in hope of building up the body of Christ. So my friend, spiritual mentoring has the same goal of building up the body of Christ by investing in the spiritual growth of another believer. The entire body is built up and unified as a more mature believer provides support and encouragement for a younger Christian. It is designed to bring unity in the faith, knowledge of Christ, and a maturity that overflows into a secure and stable trust in God that withstands the enemy's attacks. From this verse, therefore, we can glean that mentoring is much more than just developing a cross-generational friendship. It is also distinctive from a counseling relationship. The goal is not to just get to know another person better. The goal of mentoring is to know Christ in a more intimate way through the benefit and blessing of walking purposefully alongside a more mature believer. The primary goal of knowing Christ, therefore, does not in any way take away from the affection felt between the two parties. In fact, the better goal of being equipped for the work of ministry actually fosters deep intimacy between the participants in a mentoring relationship. Paul wrote to the Philippians in Philippians chapter 2, verse 22, "You know Timothy's proven worth, how as a son with a father, he has served with me in the gospel." Their relationship was not simply rooted in their affection for one another. It was centered on their work together in the gospel. And so when our desires are set upon the greater hope of knowing Christ, our affections for one another are not decreased, but rather increased. Thus, we should hope for deep devotion between a mentor and mentee. But we must also realize that a friendship is only a byproduct of a much more meaningful goal. Therefore, spiritual mentoring, with the goal of equipping the saints for the work of ministry, is greatly required in the church today. More than ever, young believers are tossed to and fro, struggling to understand truth in a generation steeped in relativism. The strong roots of older believers are needed to support younger believers so that they may grow strong in faith, be aware of and able to resist the devil's schemes, and not to be carried away by false doctrine. So, therefore, let us continue to explore this topic in further detail with the hope of providing practical insights to foster and encourage the equipping of the saints for the glory of Christ. Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the trials, tribulations, blessings, and successes in our lives, which we can use to teach others. Heavenly Father, show us the strengths we can use to mentor others and reveal areas of our lives where we could use a mentor. Give us the courage, dear Lord, to find a Christ-centered mentor and to show us who we need to mentor. Lord, you are way maker and light. And so guide us and lead us. Use us, dear Heavenly Father, to impact your kingdom and future generations in a positive way. In your precious holy name we pray. Amen.
The James Street Spicetown Circuit proudly presents the Palm Sunday Youth Rally on March 24th from 4 p.m. Prepare to be inspired, empowered, and filled with the triumphant spirit of Jesus. We're taking the theme even further this year, triumphant with Jesus, fighting like champions. This is a rallying cry for the warriors of faith. Discover how to fight life's battles with strength and courage. Big or small, this is a celebration. Hear incredible stories from young champions facing adversity and emerging victorious through unwavering faith in Jesus. Worship like never before. Our live band and praise team will lead a heart-pounding, soul-stirring celebration of Jesus' triumph. Come on, lift your voices, raise your hands, and let His Spirit fill this place. This Palm Sunday Youth Rally will be epic. Invite your friends, your family, and neighbors. Let's get this celebration echoing far beyond these walls. Save the date, mark your calendars, and prepare for the Palm Sunday Youth Rally. Triumphant with Jesus, fighting like champions. Rise, conquer, and triumph with Jesus Christ. See you there.
The risen Son.
you for being a part of our daily devotion. We trust it has been a blessing to you. Now together, let us hold fast to His word and may it dwell in all of us richly.